ceremonial before the door, and the priest offered offering, and then made the service, and then went out.
In sweet I know, in sweet I know,
yes, it is.
And the stormy winds, they'll blow. Thank the Lord for allowing us to yet be
be in the land and living in the river mine. Thank God for carrying us throughout this week, not allowing her and all the days to come upon us, but he has kept us by and through his power. We thank God for his saving power and his keeping strength. We thank the Lord now that he has died for us and how that he shed his blood that we may have a chance to be saved. So we thank God for sending his son, giving his son a mind to want to do that which is right for the saving of our souls. Knowing that if it had not been the shedding of Jesus' blood, then there would be no remission of sin. But because Jesus shed his blood for us, he has made it possible for us that our sins can be forgiven. And we thank God for the chance and the opportunity that we have to live like God's Savior, knowing that in these wicked, evil times that becomes somewhat difficult for people. But Jesus said, my yoke is easy and my burden is light. He said, take my yoke upon you. And then he said, learn of me, for I am meek and lowly in heart.
Amen.
And you shall find rest unto your soul. So we are certainly glad for the rest. We're glad for the peace.
Amen.
That the Lord gives us in these last dark evil days. He said, you know, peace I give you, peace I leave with you, not as the world. Is that right? But we thank God for his peace and we thank God for his love towards us as a people. Get the third chapter of Amos. So we're glad for the word of God, the information that God has left on record for man is for every human living. Is that right? So the word of God is written for our learning, so that we through patience and comfort of the scriptures might have hope. So we thank God for the scriptures, the things that give us the explicit information about how God wants us to live. The word of God, if we didn't have the word of God, then we wouldn't know. Just like the children of Israel when they came out of Egypt. They came out of Egypt, but then God had to give them commandments.
Amen.
After they came out, he had to give them something to govern them. Is that right? And he gave them the commandments, you know, we oftentimes say, the Ten Commandments. You know, he said, let them know, thou shalt not steal, thou shalt not kill. Is that right?
Amen.
Thou shalt not bear false witness.
Amen.
He said, amen. So God gave commandments to the children of Israel.
Amen.
Well, he's giving us commandments now. You know, and give us the things that we need to know in order to make it into heaven. Is that right? But we got to do it down here.
Yes, sir.
We got to do what's right down here in order to get up there. Got to love like the Lord say love.
Amen.
Got to have patience. Everything the Word of God says, we have to come up to that.
Amen.
Regardless of what it is that right?
Yes, sir.
And the Lord, he knows that we're nothing but dust. Here, remember, we ain't nothing but some dust.
Amen.
But then this dust got something to do if it want to be saved. Is that right? Obeying the word, striving to be what the Lord would have us to be in these last dark and the evil days. All right, third chapter of
Amos,
begin at verse 1.
Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you.
Well, hear the Lord talking now. Is that right?
Amen.
And he said, hear this word that the Lord spoken against you.
Amen.
I mean, the Lord speaks against, yes, the Lord speaks against us. Though he's for us and he loves us and he cares for us, he showed that by sending his son, Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Is that right? But he still has something against us. Is that right? Amen. Our sins, our iniquities. Is that right?
Amen.
All the things that we do that's not pleasing in his sight. Well, you know, those things, you know, is against us. And God has something against us.
Amen.
Is that right? Amen. You know, one scripture say that, you know, because there's lying and stealing, committing adultery, the Lord, there's a controversy that the Lord has with the
inhabitants
of the land. Is that right?
Amen.
There's a controversy. I got a problem with you. Because there is no truth. There is no knowledge of God in the land.
Amen.
So God got something against you. I believe it's the fourth chapter of Hosea. I believe it is. And the Lord talks about these things. Let's go over there and touch it a little bit. Then we'll come on back to Amos.
Amen. Hosea, the fourth chapter.
What it says?
Verse 1.
Yes.
Hear the word of the Lord.
Hey, now he said, in Amos, he said, hear this word.
That the Lord has spoken.
You know, that's why he says what? He that hath an ear. See, it's all about hearing. Because the scriptures say faith cometh by
hearing.
Is that right?
Yes.
And then, though you hear the word is preached, it got to be mixed with something. Word got to be mixed with something in order for it to perform or to do what it needs to do. Is that right? It is like somebody bake a cake, right? Well, all the things they put in the cake and the way the cake look, you know, it's all, when it goes into the cake pan, you know, it has all kind of ingredients. You don't see the ingredients, but it's in there. Is that right?
Amen.
Amen. You know, sugar is in there, molasses, the eggs, the butter. Is that right? See, you don't see it, but then, once the cake is done, now you can taste it.
Amen.
That's why the Lord come along and say, taste and see that the Lord is good.
Amen.
Is that right?
Yes, sir.
Amen. Then he wants us to hear the word, and then once we hear it, we put it in action, then we can taste the goodness of God. Through the obedience. Say, God is good, isn't he?
Amen.
Amen. You know, and he's good to all of us.
Yes.
Though we sometimes may not give him all the glory that's due unto him, because he's due all the praise. He's due all the praise.
Yep.
If he don't give you nothing, he has given you something.
That's right.
You already got something that belonged to him.
Amen.
Our breath. He breathed in man's nostrils, didn't he?
Amen.
And man became something. So we that's why we have to thank him for life.
Thank you, Lord Jesus.
Thank you for health and strength. Yeah, right. You might not have that money, that house, or that car that you might want. You might not even have the clothes you want. But if you got health and strength, you can breathe. Is that right?
Amen.
That's something to give God thanks for. Yeah, well, I ain't got no job yet, but you still got life. You can get one. Is that right? Amen. All right, let's see what he said, my beloved.
Amen. Hear the word. Lord. Ye children of Israel, for the Lord have a controversy with the inhabitants of the land.
He has a controversy with the inhabitants of the land.
Because there is no truth.
He has a controversy with the inhabitants of the land. We are the inhabitants of the land. So God has something against the what? The inhabitants. He has a controversy with the inhabitants of the land. Ain't that something?
Amen.
Why he has a controversy?
Because there is no truth.
Well, the first thing is because there is no truth.
No mercy.
No mercy.
Nor knowledge of God in the land.
You know, it's none. And the scripture says it's none because it's so little amount. One thing about people don't really want truth. You got to really love truth in order to want to accept and to receive it. You got to really love truth. Not in our own way, but according to the will and the way of God. We got to love truth. Like God wants us to do.
Amen.
Is that right? Go ahead, my beloved.
By swearing and lying.
Well, by swearing and lying.
And stealing and committing adultery.
Well, swearing, lying. See, God had a controversy with them happening. Is people doing these things?
Yes, sir.
Yes! That's why he got a controversy against them inhabitants. People don't mind lying to you. They'll lie to you on your job. They'll lie to you standing up looking at you. Children are lie to parents. Parents are lie to children. People just full of lies and all kinds of stuff. Is that right? And that's why the Lord says he has a controversy with the inhabitants of the land. Because there is no truth nor knowledge of God in the land. What he says.
Amen. By swearing and lying,
by swearing and lying and killing,
and stealing and committing adultery, they break out and blood touches.
They break out blood touches blood.
Therefore shall the land mourn.
Therefore shall the land mourn.
And everyone that dwelleth therein shall languish.
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 It's a problem. It's a lot of things that go on that brings about distress and brings about sorrow. And, you know, it's all over the world. Is that right?
Amen.
Because there is no knowledge of God, or truth of God in the land. Go back to Amos and it says, hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you. Is that right? O children of Israel, the third chapter of Amos. Read.
Hear this word that the Lord has spoken against you, O children of Israel.
Yes.
Against the whole family which I brought up from the land of Egypt.
Saying, he's talking about a whole family. Everybody that I brought up out of Egypt. I got a problem with you. I want you to hear something. I got something against you. The whole family that came up out of Egypt.
Amen.
What he says.
You only have I known of all the families of the earth.